night did not submerge the action at Miller Park's Healthfare Field tonight.
Yeah, some young players are clearly impervious to precipitation. John Milan, this could have been a rainout if it were the show, but these kids say, play ball!
I'll tell you what, it could have been a rainout, but the rain was really few and far between. Had some heavy downpours in some spots and other folks not getting very much. Ken and Racine, a tenth of an inch. This area, this big upper air disturbance runs from the UP all the way down to Chicago. And as we get in a little closer for you, you can see everything moving quickly to the east now at about 30 miles per hour. As I stop the radar, you'll see there's one little chance of a thunder shower. The lightning bolt has diminished there in Dodge County, some showers in Fond du Lac, Sheboygan County, and also a couple of redeveloping around Jefferson County. This is all ground clutter here. And as we pull out and show you the clouds, there's a cloud line starting to break up in western Wisconsin. We'll see some sunshine again for tomorrow. Temperatures all over the place, mid-50s near to the lake. Upper 60s to 70 in Madison, and as the winds shift more southwest by the morning hours, we're going to see those 60s move right back in. We'll start the day with about 61, 62 degrees. Look at the dew points. Down to 55 here, though that's still relatively humid, but 67 in Watertown. And again, as those winds shift to the southwest, we get more humidity in here later on tonight. So our computer models show the storm's gone. A little weak, dying storm system rolling in from western Wisconsin in the morning hours will probably die out before it gets here. We'll be mostly dry all day tomorrow. This little boundary sits right over the top of us during the day on Friday, and that could touch off some afternoon showers and again a chance for a thunder shower. So for tonight, essentially the storms are mostly over except for you folks in the northern part of the viewing area. That'll end by midnight. 61 your overnight low, partly to mostly cloudy skies, humid air. Also, it'll be warm and humid tomorrow, 80 close to the lake, 85 inland as those winds stay south west and most of the day will be dry. Most of the day should be dry on Friday. Also 76 closer to Lake Michigan, about 83, 84 inland with showers and storms possible late in the day. Here's your Storm Team 4 7-day forecast. The weekend, look for mid to upper 70s both Saturday and Sunday with a few just isolated showers or thunderstorms. No all day rains. Memorial Day right now looking pretty good with partly cloudy skies and 76 degrees. We'll see showers return on Tuesday and Wednesday with temperatures in the low 70s. Check out cute little Katie Froehling, 6 years old. She's dressed for summer, but there is an umbrella in her hand. And as we go from WeatherKid, I'd like to take a moment, just a moment, to wish my competitor over at Fox 6, Vince Candela, a happy retirement. He's moving on. This is his last day. He's going to a much warmer climate. I probably shouldn't tell people, but it's much warmer and sunnier than we have here most of the year. We wish him all the best.
Good luck, Vince.
Absolutely.